Ballroom dancers, what's happening? Welcome back to my living room for another quarantine version of ballroom dance. Today we're going to do something a little bit different, pardon me, than we've been doing. We're going to do Foxtrot, which I believe we did last time, but this is going to be part one of, I think it's going to be a four-part series. Let's see if we can get it done in four parts. We're going to work on a choreography so that we all have something we're aiming for rather than learning some disparate pieces that we never really put together. We're gonna do a choreography. We're gonna do it to Nat King Cole's Orange Colored Sky. I believe there's only one version. If for some reason that's different, I will post that in the comments. In addition to us doing this slightly differently, I would like you guys to do something different as well. It would be awesome if you could record yourselves doing each section of the choreography and post that in the comments, if that's at all possible. I would love to see it and I'd love to comment and give you some feedback. Can you do it? Please, let's do it. Let's do a little bit of a warm-up. So I'm just gonna start with my left foot, and I'm gonna go forward, back. Might as well turn this music up. Back. So Foxtrot is one of the easier social dances, at least at the beginning. Let's go right foot forward. It's danced to big band, jazzy type music, usually in 4/4 timing. Let's go to the side. And then let's go back forward. We'll get to choreography in a second. Actually, let me put on Orange Colored Sky right now while we're warming up. Now right foot forward. Now to the side and... Yeah, so I just typed Orange Colored into Spotify songs, and it's the first one that comes up that we're going to use. There we go. This is not slow. It's pretty fast. Let's do our warm-up. And we go. And we go full. So notice the music has a little bit of a bounce to it. And as I've been talking now, for as long as I've been dancing, but now for a couple of weeks here on social media and these videos, dancing is all about a response to music. And I know sometimes we're trying to learn patterns and things like that, so we separate it from the music just to try to understand how movement works. But this is kind of gonna be a focus of how we're reacting to the music and how we're changing with the music. That being said, this song has this kind of driving beat to it, so it would be nice to be able to have a little bit of that in our steps as well, a little bounce, a little bit of sway, rather than just stepping while we're dancing, right? Let's learn a little bit of this pattern, and I'm going to talk to you more about why I think this pattern works well for our current situation, meaning a tight space. Let's go over the very beginning of it. So if you've done the Foxtrot basic before, you will know this step, how we're going to change it a little bit. We're going to take two steps forward, and then we're going to go two steps to the side, right? Follow the same thing, but it's all backwards, two steps. We're going to do that twice. So notice I keep drifting this way. So if I angle towards my fireplace here or to my right, I should be able to make a straight line, side close, side close, and then I can fit it in the room pretty easily. Ideally, we would be dancing something like this in a massive ballroom so we could take really, really big steps. But really what we have to do is change it and manipulate it for what the environment calls for. Most of the time in social settings, we can't move very big, especially like a swing club or jazz club where we might hear the kind of music we would dance this to. It's gonna be kind of a confined space. So we need to be accustomed to dancing big if we can and small. Let me just show you what that might look like if I were dancing this full out and I had the space to do it. I would take two big steps here and then side close, and I have enough space to do one of those in this living room. So what I'm gonna do is shrink everything. I'm still gonna have that same feeling of Foxtrot. I'm just not gonna take such a big stride. Got it, so keep that in mind. If you have to take even smaller steps, great. If you have a bigger space, then take bigger steps. Use what you have. So one more time, let me show the followers part. So the followers drifting this way as well, so I'm gonna back, put my butt towards the fireplace. So I go one, two, side, close, one, two, side, close, got it, that part is pretty easy. For those of you who feel like you've done something like this before and you want a little bit of a challenge, do both the leaders and the followers parts. There's no reason not to learn that. What I found when I was going through dance exams is that when I had to learn the other perspective, I became a much better dancer in both. So think about it and try it. After that, this is where it gets kind of fun and challenging. So I'm just gonna do the second one. So I've already done the first basic with the exercise close. I'm gonna do one more, and then I'm gonna do eight rocks in place. So I'm gonna step forward and notice I'm turning my hips here, and I'm gonna keep my back heel up. So that's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. On eight, I can roll back into that heel. I only went around once. Really, we want to try to go around twice. So we go slow, slow, quick, 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 quick. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Got it? One more time, and then we're gonna move on. Actually, let me do the following part. So this is the second basic. Jump, bam, ba-dum, bam, bam, bam. My heel stays up as well. Back heel, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now I'm coming forward this way, right foot is free. So leader, we're gonna go back on our left foot after those rocks. We're gonna go back, back. Now I'm gonna turn 90 degrees and just do a side close. Side close. So I'll do the eight rocks. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Fudge that, that's okay. Then it's gonna be back, back, side, close. For the follow, it's gonna be forward, forward. Not side close though. So it's back, back, jump, bump, bump, bump. One, two, three, four, five. I just go around seven, eight. Sorry, I should be here. We're gonna go forward, forward, quick, quick. So just two little forward steps. What's happening here is that the leader, as the leader goes side close, is pulling the follower past. So if you've done something like a crossbody lead in salsa or a crossbox lead in waltz or rumba or something like that, that's kind of what we're doing here. So as the leader, I take my steps back, I'm gonna open up and then pull my follower through. The follower is gonna come through, forward, 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 forward. That's already quite a bit, isn't it? I think we need to get a little bit more done, but why don't we try that from the top once without music, and then I'll do it with music, both parts. We go slow, slow, quick, 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 slow, slow, quick, 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 quick. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Slow, slow. A quick, quick. That was the leader's part, obviously. The follower's parts. Back, back, side, close, back, back, side, close. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Slow, slow, quick, quick. Let's try it to music.
I think this started sagging here. There we go.
That's better. Here we go.
And we go. I was walking along, minding my business, without an orange color sky.
Music nicely. I just love it. Some of my students have done this choreography before. At the studio, we have different levels of choreography for different songs. Most of you maybe aren't even aware of that. This is kind of an intermediate level choreography to this song. Let's try the followers part. And we
go. I was walking along, minding my business, when out of an orange color sky.
Like the bank, Alcazette,
wonderful you came on. I was hung with children.
Lovely.
Drinking in sunshine.
Such a good song. So there are all these cool parts.
Out of that orange color.
That's why I chose this song. We'll do some rocks here again. Listen to the texture of this song.
I gotta look at you. One looking eye of timber.
Oh, that's so much fun. Okay, so let me do the leader's part. Just finish the rocks. Back, back, side, close. I want to do everything backwards. So I need to collect my follower and then come back this way. So the follower's over here. I'm going to go through my follower's center. So now we're facing each other. And then I'm going to go back, back, side, close, side, close. Let's just talk about that through moment because that can be a little bit tricky. It requires us to squeeze everything to stop the momentum. So the follower's energy is going this way as they come past. Back, back, side, close. So I have to make sure I'm leaning back here and squeezing everything to stop. And then I'm gonna go back, back, side, close, back, back, side, close. Notice what I did there is that I did one step and I held it so that I could get onto the opposite foot. So the rocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We go back, back, side, close, squeeze, back, back, side, close, back, back, side, close. So really I'm doing the followers part. Followers, we just finished the rocks. We're gonna go forward, forward, forward together, back. Now we're ready to come forward. Forward, forward, side, close, forward, forward, side, close. And then we do the rocks right away at that point. And I think we're gonna have to put a pause on it there. That's already a lot of info. As I've said before with these videos, if you feel like you've learned enough, you don't have to watch the whole video, get through the whole thing in one sitting. You can watch it, pause it, come back to it later, learn it. Like I said, this is part one of probably four. And if at any point you feel like you need to go back to remember, it's best not to just continue to push forward if you don't remember something earlier on. Get this down, then move on. You have a week, actually. It's going to be next Monday that I show you part two of this choreography. Let's add the rocks at the end, and then we're going to try the whole thing. So I'm the leader, and I'm going to go back on my right foot after I did that little collection step here. So I'm going back, back, side, close, back, back. Now I rock here. Right foot back for me, just like the follower was doing originally. And I'm going left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I really will get around one more time, but I'm ready to go back this direction. Notice I didn't put my weight on my right foot on 8, I put my weight on my left foot. One more time, so just that second one. Yum, bump. Bump, 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 bump. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then I'm ready to move back this way, which we'll do next time. Followers, we're here. We're going forward, forward, side, close, forward, forward, 1, 2, 3. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ready to go forward again. One more time for the follower. Left foot. Let's just do the second basic forward. Forward, forward, side, close, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ready to move this way. Let me show you the followers, I'm sorry, the leader and the followers part one more time, and then we're gonna do it with music. So all the way from the top, leader's part goes slow, slow, quick, 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 slow, slow. A quick, 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 quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Slow, slow. A quick, quick, slow, 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 a quick, 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 quick. Now I'm backwards. And we go to the rocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I'm ready to go backwards. Followers, let's do your part from the top. Part of me doesn't even want to say leader and follower here because you should just really learn both parts, like I said. And I'm not intending this to be danced with another person, even though originally choreography is meant that way. I think you can dance this by yourself and learn some musicality and learn this movement and learn the technique without having to worry about a partner. So even if you have a partner to dance with at home, don't even necessarily worry about that. Have fun doing it yourself. Followers part. Here we go. Back, side, close, back, back. Side, close, side, close. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Slow, slow, but quick, quick, slow, 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 quick, 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 slow, slow. Now we rock again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Slow, slow. There we have it. Let me do it with the music, and then we're going to call it a day. Like I said, if you do this choreography, I would love to see you guys dance. So even if you just send it to me a private message, do it that way, a direct message, I guess is what they're called here on Instagram. Let's try some music from the top. Here we go. And we go.
I was walking along, minding my business, without an arm.
Okay, followers part.
I was walking along, minding my business, without an orange color sky.
Flash,
bang,
Alcatraz.
Here we go. Sweet. I totally messed the footwork up there. But it doesn't matter. I don't even remember what I did wrong. So that's the beginning of the choreography. This is part 1 of 4. So if you find yourself at part 4 of 4 in the future, and this is your first time watching this, this is the right place for you. 1 of 1. This is new. I hope you all had fun with that. Let's see, today is Monday. It's hard to keep track of days, isn't it? Wednesday, I've got the Shim Sham, some swing stuff we're working on. This is a little kind of like bit of solo choreography we're gonna do. It's a lot of fun. I really like it. So join us then. Song today, Orange Colored Sky, Nat King Cole. Enjoy it. Post your videos so I can see you guys dancing. Later.